let's say as an experiment. I know you haven't researched this exactly, but let's say we would try to find, single out the most lucky person in the world. He or she would obviously live in Norway.
Or Denmark or Sweden.
No, but Norway is number one, isn't it?
Norway is number one, yeah. Well, you know, this is a different question. So,
let's ask that.
And I'll guess, okay?
Yeah,
but
okay.
I want to hear the others guess,
Is
too.
It their personality that makes them happy, or because they, you know, they haven't been hit by the recession that badly and everything's expensive?
Well, good
for
question.
For us.
I mean, you know, I mean,
they're laughing that they can charge us £50 for a napkin.
Well, that is true.
That's the riot.
And that's a form of happiness, I suppose, if you're on one side
that's
of the table.
That's the American.
Well, happiness, here are two thoughts for you, okay? First of all, we individuals, we human beings are infinitely complex, right? So even, I'm gonna suggest to you, the happiest person who is self-confident and secure and successful and rooted in family and community surely has self-doubt, anxiety, concerns, worries, and all that. You know, we're human beings, we're complex. But to your question more specifically, you know, who is the happiest person and are they in Norway?
The luckiest, yes.
Yeah, luckiest. You know, here's a guess for you, but I want to hear your opinion. I would say that what do we human beings have in common that make us happy? Three things. One is autonomy. We don't like being ruled over. We want space. We want freedom, right? The second thing is, even though we want space and freedom and autonomy, we like being rooted in something. You know, it's a family, or it's a community, or it's a tradition, but we don't like being rootless. And then the third thing I would say is purpose, right? It could be spirituality, it could be children, it could be a political cause, it could be a novel that you're working on and you have to get out of your system and soul, but freedom, being rooted, and some purpose in some way. But I think you find that person in Norway and Sri Lanka and Canada and Costa Rica and everywhere.
Sigmund Freud has said that, written that a healthy person is a person that has ability for love and work. And I think that's very essential.
Right. Mm. That sounds good to me, but I don't know if Sigmund Freud was very happy with it.
That was another finding. Another finding that you did is that USA has dropped out of the top 10 list.
It has, our country.
Knew it would happen.
Okay.
Yeah.
But well, first, this is quite surprising.
Well,
actually, isn't
well it is,
not.
Of course. Well, what do you mean? Of course it is. You know, top 10, we should be in the top 10.
Yeah, but we're not. We've been sinking for 20 years.
Well, that actually may be true. And so the first thing is, this is a snapshot, okay? And to be meaningful, you have to look at trends. And I'm afraid, you know, Ruby may be right. You know, we have a debt problem in the United States. We spend more than we can afford and all sorts of things.
We're envious, we're greedy, we're everything that makes you crazy.
Well, but I don't think only Americans are envious, for example.
You know? No, but not at that rate, not at that intensity.
But I thought there was a term called the American dream, that you really believed
that
you could make it.
Yeah, but that's why it's backlashed, is that people think there is an American dream, and now we're so opposite what that was supposed to be, that we're miserable. Yeah. And we've been faking it for 40 years, going, have a nice day. Nobody was.
But it's not miserable. You don't look miserable. I'm not miserable.
I don't live there.
Do you believe there's any correlation between depression in a country and the lack of prosperity?
When they're very poor, they have depression, and when they're very rich, they have depression. You know, like, when there's a lot of money, it causes depression, and when there's absolutely no money, it can cause depression.
Because too much is bad and too little is bad.
You want too much down here, and you're too worried that you're going to lose it up there. You know, so there's stress on both levels, I think. You know, these guys don't want to, you know, they don't need too much. And that's really the road to happiness, when you don't need things, accoutrements, and certainly Norwegians. You know, it's just unbelievably beautiful. What do you need jewelry for?
Jeffrey, thank you so much for coming here tonight.
Great pleasure. Thank you.
Ettersom vi sitter I BBC's legendariske studio, welcome Jeffrey Gidman.
Thank you. Welcome.